Hello. What do we think of when we consider architecture and the environment?
This is actually a film about the European community, my liege.
Oh, damn. Well, you just sort of get on with it and let me know when I can help, as it were.
Now with serious contemplation, we assess the British nation to discover if we can the true blue Englishman. Take this opportunity to address this great community with a comprehensive plan, a market-researched plan to explain with objectivity every custom and activity of the average British man. The elusive, inconclusive, unobtrusive British working man.
Here, what about us ladies?
The ladies, God love them. Don't worry, girls, you'll be featured. Emily Bronte, Florence Nightingale, Vera Lynn, you know, that sort of thing.
The British are a nation of considerable antiquity who colonized the globe with quite remarkable ubiquity. They turn up everywhere from Abu Dhabi to Nigeria and quickly show the natives what it is to be superior.
And the thing is, we're so frightfully modest about it all.
The British are a multicolored polyglot society, descended from invaders of most dubious variety. Their pedigree is Viking, Anglo-Saxon, Teuton, Aryan, with bits of Hun and Huguenot, but basically barbarian.
With bits of Hun and Huguenot, but basically barbarian.
The British are devoted to the arts and intellectual, at sport enthusiastic, but entirely ineffectual. They've patented inventions of amazing ingenuity. Their efforts gastronomical are viewed with ambiguity.
Their efforts gastronomical are viewed with ambiguity.
The British are a monarchy in love with ceremonial, impressed by pomp and circumstance and palaces baronial. The royals all conduct themselves with dignified sobriety, and so the British tabloids always treat them with propriety.
And so the British tabloids always treat them with propriety.
The British are eccentric, unreserved and unconventional, stiff upper lipped and buttoned up, high-bound and condescensional, permissive and profane and positively puritanical, bohemian and Bluesbury bucolic and botanical.
Bohemian and Bluesbury bucolic and botanical.
That's all very well, but isn't it all a bit, you know, I mean, sort of frightfully, kind of vague? Can't we name a few names? You know, Shakespeare, Dickens, God?
That bit's coming up now, sir.
Famous British men, wielding sword and pen. Shelley, Byron, Drake and Raleigh. Don't forget my Uncle Charlie, Darwin, Newton, Wren. Famous British men. Famous names galore, Keats and Bernard Shaw. Chaucer, Dickens, Emily Bronte, Churchill, Vera Lynn and Monty saved us in the war. Famous names galore, and there's Roger Moore. Shakespeare, well, of course, and Inspector Morse. Pitt and Gladstone and Disraeli, Heseltine and Arthur Daly. Redrum, what a horse! Worcester and his sauce, what a tour de force!
You can't count our British heroes on your fingers or your toes. Is it something in the diet or the beer, do you suppose?
Actually, I think it's something to do with the climate.
Good idea, my lord. We're just in time for the weather.
The flowers that bloom in the spring are frequently covered in snow. Our climate's a funny old thing. The birds that arrive on the wing soon think of a reason to go.
Au revoir. Wiedersehen. Cheerio.
We never know whether or what to expect. I blame British Rail and the greenhouse effect.
Next time, my umbrella I bring.
Splendid, oh splendid. But I do wish you could sort of jolly it along a bit. Well, there won't be any time for my speech. It's about architecture, you know?
Right, chaps. Wheel on the finale.
After serious contemplation of the glorious British nation,
thank you.